Let's talk to Bill Blain. He's a strategist at Shard Capital. Very good morning to you, Bill.
Good morning,
Liz. Right, the stopwatch is on your box. Let's have a soapbox session.
Well, you know, it's a tough day to be giving a kind of this is what's going to happen talk, because today we got the US midterm elections. The consensus here on Tuesday morning in London is that we're going to see the Democrats get a small majority in Congress, and the Republicans will hold on to the Senate.
Now, gridlock.
It's effectively a form of gridlock. It won't give the Democrats much power because they'll always be vulnerable to people not being there or being turned, and it will stop much of what Trump is trying to do. There's a lot of people are saying that that's a market positive because it will stop Trump doing anything more maniacal. I mean, there are a lot of people say this is a heart trade, that, you know, we've had enough.
Yep.
But at the same time, it stops Trump being able to deliver the kind of positives he has delivered. Whatever the liberal lefties say, Trump has delivered tax cuts which have boosted the US economy. He's also made significant changes in terms of getting appointees through the system. That's all going to be gridlocked over the next couple of, at least the next 2 years. So we got that to contend with. It really depends about what the actual numbers are tonight and just how small that majority, or possibly even not seeing the Democrats take Congress. If that happens, we get a completely different thing. So I could sum it up for viewers. If we get a Democratic Congress, gridlock, mildly market positive. If we do see the Republicans hold on to Congress,
yep,
then we're into a completely different game. We will be into more of the same, and that is very market positive.
Yep.
It's market positive. It's not necessarily morally positive, but that's not what we're here to talk about.
So in terms of the markets, you would be long ahead of the outcome of this then?
I don't see much risk ahead of it. We are going to get certainty, and certainty is always good. And the likelihood is that certainty is not going to be a destructive Congress lock. It's going to be difficult. It's not going to be destructive. If you get a very large Democratic majority, and if you were to see the Senate swing, which I think was only a 1 in 5 chance of happening, that's when we have to reassess. But it's very unlikely. So we're going to get a slightly better market. We're going to get certainty. We've just had a big market correction. We've got the bond market looking poised to go lower.
Yep.
But it looks like the stock market has certainly got room to recover. We've had a decent earnings season.
Share buybacks can now
Can recommence. I'm not convinced that share buybacks are ever a good thing, but Warren Buffett thinks they are, and he knows far more than I do,
yep,
so I'll go with that.
Right, what about the trade war?
Well, the trade war looks like it's going to come to some kind of solution in Singapore. But I reckon that Trump is going to want to keep up the pressure. Trump is quite happy to trade in the short term US jobs and growth because of the amount of pain it's inflicting on China. He knows if he continues to do this that America is going to be the long-term beneficiary. So there's no particular rush for Trump to give in or to make it easy for Xi. I think it's far more likely we continue to see pressure there. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, because at the end of the day, there will be an agreement. It will be much better. One of the trades that I'm thinking about just now is just the downright obvious one. It's been a terrible year for many assets. We've seen many deals, many stocks really suffer through,
yep,
the year. Maybe this is the time to start thinking about the contrarian buy the cheap deals. Volatility is not an issue. It's trying to pick up things when they look more sensibly priced. And we do seem to be getting there in many of the tech stocks and many areas like banking. And I think there are risks out there. There are major risks out there, in fact, with some stocks, especially European banks, to my mind. But certainly many of these things do look cheap, especially in Europe. But there are problems coming up next year. And in the UK, where I think we will get some kind of Brexit solution, which is a definite buy signal, and in the US.
Okay, so obviously Brexit, a good outcome, you would assume the stock market would be at 7,700, not down to 7,000, okay? Mm-hmm. When the sort of the commentary I've seen, we're 95% there, okay? How do you factor that in? 95% is not 100%.
This is the stuff of comic programs, you know, 95% done. It's not done till it's done. It's immaterial to talk about if you've still got the biggest solution to do. But I have had a sense throughout the whole process that markets are always going to assume the worst, because market news gets magnified by what we see in the media. And the media is having a field day as characterizing everyone that's involved in this as a complete and utter numpty. There isn't one single person you can go out to in the streets of Britain today that thinks this has been at all well handled, and they are blaming politicians. But there are many issues to be sorted. They will get sorted. It just looks very messy. At the end of the day, we will get an agreement. It might be an agreement that, you know, people who really care about just what the border rules look like are going to be dissatisfied with. But Britain is going to effectively end up outside of Europe, and we're going to have a trading relationship long term with them. That's going to happen. When it's clear that it has happened, markets will get back on track.
So, equities from here to Christmas, higher or lower?
I think we're going to see something of a consolidation phase in the equity market, with some stocks looking particularly good value, especially those that have taken a spanking.
Yep.
Where my main concerns lie are in the bond market. I think it very likely that the strength we've seen in the US economy and recovery here in Europe, and also the strength of economies like Germany, but not the whole of Europe, mean that we're going to see higher rates. We're also going to see the consequences of the last 10 years of QE really start to hit the bond market. Now, you can have a situation where you've got stocks remaining strong on good earnings and growth, and the bond market falling because of the anticipation of higher rates. But what really does concern me is just how over-levered the whole corporate market has become over the last 10 years, where they borrowed enormous amounts of money at very, very cheap rates because of QE and artificially low interest rates. They've got to repay that money. Effectively, what they've done borrowing all that money is convert equity into debt, because they've used that cash to buy back their own stock.
Yep.
They haven't built plant. They haven't built productive capacity. They haven't added anything to the net sum of human wealth, except if you're an executive on the board of these companies because you got bigger bonus because your stock price went up, or you were the owner of a leveraged firm where you were able to transfer that equity into debt and repay it yourself as a dividend. It's been an extremely dangerous transfer of cash from the stock market into the hands of owners.
On that note, Bill,
that's what we need to worry about next year. You know what? I'm sure we'll be talking about it.
I'm sure we will.
Thank you.
Thank you.